Welcome to another episode of our training. In this episode, I am going to show you how to crack a password using different tools in your pen test lab. So I'm going to be working with my Linux. I don't think my Parrot is up right now. I'm going to be working with my Linux. So let me just quickly show you that right now. So I will log into my Linux, and then very easy to do this. I'm going to create an MD5 files, which is to hash it for me. I'm gonna create password and hash them with MD5. So how to do that? I will use a command called echo. Okay, it seems I already have that. So echo do not output, because I want to write it into, I want to send the output into the MD5 to calculate the hash for me. And then while the awk is going to print out, you know, the calculated hash, and then send it to the file I'm going to create. So let's go there. So I'm gonna call this, let's say maybe dog, for example. Let's say I use dog as my password, and then I'm going to say pipe it to MD5 sum, and then the output again, I will send it to awk, which is going to calculate and format, you know, the hash values, you know. That's it. So print $1. So this is to print the values out. So then I will write it into a file. What will I call it? My hash. Call it my hash.txt, right? I just want to put it that way. I can actually do it this way, you know, to be more, you know, my hash.txt. So if I do this, enter, so it has created the first password. Okay, before we continue, if I list, we can see the file name, that the file name is my hash. So if I cat my hash, cat is used to display content of a file. So if you want to learn Linux basics, let me know in the comment section so I can actually take you on that. If you want to sign up for your classes, let me know, online, offline, physical, just let me know. You know, you can send me a direct DM, you can drop it in the comment section, just let me know how you feel so I can take you on that. So if you want to sign up for cybersecurity, ethical hacking, cloud computing, networking, systems administration, even incident response, so just let me know anyone that you want to sign up for. So let's continue. So I will say cat my hash.txt. So you can see I have a hash value. So this is the password what it's been converted to. So this is how actually your Windows systems store your password in the SAM, security asserted markup language, you understand. So here, so if I go back to create folder, to write folder into the file by using the double arrows now. So this time around, I'm going to change this to password. You know, a lot of people use this, leave their default password like this. Then I'm going to write another one. I will call it just admin. You know, some of these vendors will use admin as password, and some users will not change it. They will leave it like that. And some of them will use, let's say, even user, you know, as their password. And some of them will use password 123. So I'm still going to do that. So we do password 123. Let's try this, password 123. All right. And then in the next one, let's do pass me in and see what pass me in. A lot of people use all this, pass me in. And then the last one that we are going to create, let's create something like password $2, password $2. All right, enter. So if I now go back and say cat, right, my hash.txt, I have how many? I have a couple of this is 3 plus 4, 5, 6, 7. So I have 7 hash. So now There are three tools that we can actually use in the Linux. There are three tools that I actually want to demonstrate that we can actually use. But two of them, my system will not be able to do that at the moment, unless I switch to my other system. But for this system, I am only going to work with John the Ripper. I will not be able to show you Hashcat. I will not be able to show you Rainbow Crack, because this might actually, you know, be overwhelming in terms of the memory. So let's just use John the Ripper. But if you want me to use Hashcat, I can actually show you how to do that. But then it's going to give me error because my memory is not enough that I assigned to this lab. So let's work with John the Ripper first. So here, if you can, if you want to do John the Ripper, you can do this John, then iPhone Hedge to see the, you know, what it contains. So here, now, let's see if we can go down to see, I'm sorry about that. I wanted to go up to show you some things. It's obvious my lab is misbehaving. I'm sorry about that. So let me clear the screen, you know. So now I will use John the Ripper to catch the password. So how do I do that? I just say John and then format equal to, remember I told you I was using MD5, message digest 5, to hash the password. So in that case, I'm gonna bring that up, MD5 equal to, and then the name is my hash.txt. So let's watch how many passwords we are going to be able to crack right here now. So let us see. So you can see that we have dog. So you see why it's not good to use something too simple to make it your password. That's why you see that organizations will use a complex password, and they'll have what we call password policy. So that's why you need to use a complex password, combination of alphanumeric characters, you know, lowercase and uppercase combined together. So don't use something too simple. You can see the admin is out there, and then the dog is out there. And then now, one thing about John the Ripper is that if it tries to look for the password in the word list and it's not found, it's going to just switch to what incremental to go online to look for it. So now incrementing, I'm going to be tapping the enter key, you know, I need to keep tapping. I'll press it and hold it down for it to go and start looking for the password, since it's not able to find them in the word list. So let's see what we can get in that aspect. So you notice this is going to take a long time. So if you know you have patience to wait, you can actually hold on while it fetches the password for you. So that is how to crack using what the format. So I'm going to show you the second one using wordlist direct. So instead of this, I'll move this, all right? In this case, watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to now put the directory that this file is located. Directory is home. So how do I know that it's in home? So let's just let's do something. So let me show you this pwd where I'm working from. So you can see I'm working from home/home/kali. All right. So that's where. And if I say list, you see that the file is there. So it means I'm working from my home directory. So that is where I want to go now, so that we can be able to do this. So in that case, I'm going to go to I'm changing this to word list. So I'll go to word list, all right? Let's see, word list equal to the path of this word list that we want to use, path share, user share, and then word list slash rock you, that's what contains the txt, and then space, I'll put the directory, this is home/kali, right, slash again. Now let's try this and see if we get to crack more passwords, right? Let's see. So it says completed, right? So something is definitely, it says loaded seven password hashes with no different salts, right? So you can see we've already cracked the password using the other one. So it says remaining two password hashes with no different salt. So in this case, now let's see something. Let's try to see John. Let's see. So John, I'm gonna see John. Let's see if we can. I'm trying to see if we can actually get to see the password, those passwords that we've cracked. Just give me a moment, please. Let me, I'll check my mobile phone. Just have important thing. Just 1 minute, please. Okay, so don't worry, I'm coming. Just hope that this is not. Just give me 1 minute. Right, so I'm gonna do this. Let's see. Okay, let's just see if we can go and the same command, nothing changes. So let's see. Go back to format equal to MD raw MD5. I just want to see if we can have those password. My, remember the name of the file is my hash.txt. Let's see something. Oh, good. So we are able to crack 5 passwords out of the 7. So 2 are left, which we need to use incremental. So I've taught you 2 different ways we can use John the Ripper to crack passwords. So the first one was the normal format, raw MD5, and the second one is going through the word list, and the third one is this one I'm going to show you. So you can see we have pass me in password 123 admin and then password. So please, I'm going to be advising you, do not use something too common for someone to guess, or do not use something too common, because most of these things are contained in the online something that has been breached online, the password that have been breached online. So you don't need to keep repeating them, because it what list is going there to check. So right now let's go to the last one, John. Let's use incremental to do that. John or incremental. So that means my hash.txt, hit enter, and then you have to be, so you can see what's going on. Then you have to be pressing the enter button to check, you know, keep pressing them and to keep fetching different username and passwords, you know. So you can hold it down and wait for it, and then till it fetches the password for you. So this brings us to the end of this lab demonstration. And if you want me to demonstrate Hashcat, how to crack password using Hashcat, and how to crack password using Rainbow Crack, let me know so in the comment section. And if you like this video, just subscribe to my channel, and then subscribe to my YouTube channel, and then hit on the like button. And then it is the same name that we have on Facebook page. So most of these videos are also on the Facebook page. So you can also watch this on our Facebook page, and then like and follow us as well. So see you in our next episode, and let me know how you feel in the comment section. All right. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode.